Hey guys, give me 1 minute. I just gotta get everything set up here. Just one bit. Okay, looks like everything's ready to go. Adjust my chair here. There we go. Well, for those of you just joining me, welcome back, or at least welcome to the stream. Tonight's subject is Green Lantern. What I'm using, it's going to be basically, instead of a painting or anything like that, it's just going to be basic pencil and then inks. So we're going to go with that. The Green Lantern I chose today is Kyle Rayner. He's the Green Lantern after Hal Jordan, before the rebuild of the Green Lantern Corps. So he's kind of the He, I used to kind of hate the character, but over time, I actually grown to love him and kind of appreciate the fact that he was essential to the series. So what I'm using is a bristle or Strathmore bristle board. It's a smooth ply on one side. On the other side, it's a more like a toothy surface. But I'd rather use the smooth surface because when you lay down inks, it actually looks a lot nicer, like especially how it feels too. What I did earlier today, because I kind of just didn't want to spend, 20, 30 minutes on trying to find the right pose or anything like that. I did that ahead of time, and then I found the particular pose that I wanted, and I just did a layout on it with a 2H lead on a mechanical pencil. I actually added this little pencil holder or pencil, I don't want to call it a pencil holder, but more of like a pencil pillow. It's an old one that I used to have back in high school, but decided to throw it on here because it actually makes the whole thing feel a bit more comfortable to mess with. But I'm going to go ahead and flesh this out a little bit further using the pencil, and then I'm going to erase it with a neat eraser, and then jump on to tightening the pencils. And then and after that, I'll go straight to inks, which I'll be using several pens and brushes for that. So, let's get this started. Put that there. Oop, forgot my other eraser. There we go. And I'll jump around here, kind of see what areas that needs a little bit more attention that I need to kind of fix. Now, I was debating on with his hair. He used to have when he first appeared in the comics, he had a bit of a haircut that was like kind of split in the middle. But that fashion hairstyle does not compute nowadays. It's not unless you're like super lazy and just don't want to get a haircut. You just let the hair kind of grow out as is. But for this one, doesn't really need that anymore, so... And the idea with this one, I kind of want to put them in a space setting. I'm debating whether or not I should actually color him via Photoshop. I think that would be a kind of a fun thing to do tonight after the stream. Actually, I do need to sharpen this pencil. Make sure this... No. All right. The idea with this is, well, with like at least penciling it, is that I don't want to put too much pressure on the actual pencil. I want to keep it, you know, even with a sharp lead, I kind of want to keep it light. That's the reason why I have this here, is to kind of give me a guide to actually keep my to hold my pencil at a distance and not too close like here. So that's the trick about tightening up pencils, is that you want to keep your pencil, or at least like laying out, you want to keep your pencils, you know, try to keep them as light as possible, because once you erase, you don't want the lines becoming permanent, or at least leaving an impression in the end. Along the way, I'm using references to kind of remind myself of what his masks look like. Once again, I said this in past streams, and I'll say it here. References are your best friend. Don't feel like it's a forbidden thing to do. I think people who say that references aren't, is like cheating, well, and then you kind of need to, I mean, I'm pretty sure there are people out there who are, who don't need it and are fine with it, fine without it, but sometimes there are certain images or certain, objects that, you know, need that extra attention to detail. So references are kind of a great way to help with that, you know, kind of get a good idea of what, how it's supposed to look, instead of doing anything, you know, by memory. Now, it's not, you know, you don't need references for everything, but just a few things will help. Yeah, that should do it. Do you remember this one time while working for a particular issue of Dusk, for Dusk Comics, I was actually doing an inking job, and the artist I was working for, you know, did some great artwork and everything, you know, pages look good, but there's a few things that, you know, this artist missed out on, and that is doing basically drawing backgrounds and drawing like everyday objects differently. And you know, at that time, you know, I was still new to the whole thing, and I really wanted to you know, give my best effort, especially as, you know, doing an inking job. I really wanted to, you know, push as much as possible to make sure that, you know, I'm giving it my best. And, you know, when I saw the pages, and I saw, and I'll give you a really good example, there was this image of a table. Hey, Krista. There's an image of this table that this artist drew, and it just didn't look right. It's kind of hard to explain. Essentially, it's the table was supposed to be facing towards the reader, and from one end to another, and the legs were, you know, front end for the legs were fine, but the back end was, you know, two of the legs for the back end were sticking out like a, like basically, let me show you, essentially like, so there's your legs, and mind you, it's only how, you know, it depends on like where the camera or where the camera is focusing on. So if the table was, you know, a little bit lower, then you can see the back of the legs, but this artist ended up putting out the legs kind of far out here, which kind of drove me batty. I kind of freaked out on that. And I had to stop myself to go like, you know what, you know, this is a lesson for the artist. You know, references are your best friend. They, you know, if, you know, and I didn't want to be the person to quickly like, you know, judge how the piece looks and blah, blah, blah. I just rather come out there and say, hey, you know, the work looks really good. You just need to kind of know how to, or you just need to, you know, if you're not sure how a particular thing, how an item or an object looks, you know, definitely use references. It's not gonna kill you. And I'm pretty sure this artist, you know, took my advice to heart, and I think, you know, about a year later, I see this person's, you know, artwork on another book that they were working on, and the improvement was, like, massively big. Like, you know, they actually took the time to actually, you know, pull out the references and know, like, what they're doing. So, like, their pages turned out to be 100% better. Like, when I first saw that person's pages, you know, they were good, but when I gave that artist that advice, it was, you know, it was a vast change, and it looked good. So, you know, and that's what you kind of need. I mean, you kind of need somebody to come up to you and be like, hey, you know, this looks good, but let's improve on it. Let's make this thing, let's make this thing awesome. So, yeah, and I remember this artist actually, especially drawing guns, didn't draw them, you know, by, like, oh, you know, the handle and it how basically the mechanics of how a gun should look, you know, didn't draw it the way most guns should look. Essentially, it was just one rectangle cube on top of another, and it just looked really off. It looked really, really off. So I would jump in and during the inking process, I would correct those pieces or the objects and kind of make it look like it's supposed to be.
Even with a car, which I was kind of... I was surprised myself because, you know, I wasn't too good with drawing cars. But, you know, I was always, you know, I was always big on making sure that, you know, that if I was going to make it look like something, that it needs to, you know, it needs to look like that. So, you know, pull out the references and kind of study them and then go from there and did that. So, you know, in hindsight, I feel like I shouldn't have done that, but when you're, you know, when you're publishing a, you know, a particular book, you want to make sure that that piece is, that, you know, the pages don't look off, that they actually are what they are, that the items and the cars and the buildings look like they're supposed to be. So... But if anybody has any questions, feel free to ask. I'll check periodically on the stream to kind of see who wants to have a few words with me. Not in a threatening manner. Hopefully not in a threatening manner. I hope it's not a threatening manner. And hell, even after the stream, I know I usually have this posted up, fully recorded, and posted up on the Facebook page. So, if you got any questions or comments, feel free to post them on here. You know, it's not. I am not against anybody, putting their input on here. All I ask is that, you know, don't troll. So that's my big thing, is don't go to a stream and start trolling people. I mean, that just is uncalled for. One thing I always found funny about Kyle's armor is that his gauntlets are always like super huge. This is a product of the 90s. Everything had to be big in some fashion with like either the arms or the legs. But I think they were kind of a, you know, kind of a cool thing to have. Especially, you know, when this character came, well, you know, this character was introduced, he wasn't, you know, it was a brand new character. You know, I'm pretty sure the writers and the artists were kind of like, we don't know if this guy's going to last, because this is during the time when Hal Jordan became evil and essentially just killed the Green Lantern Corps. There was one remaining ring that that one of the guardians of the Corps brought to Kyle. And it's kind of a weird introduction, because essentially I forgot the guardian's name. It's Gauntlet, or not that looked that up another time, but he just comes in, sees Kyle, and goes, "Oh, well, you'll do," and then just gives him the ring. And that was kind of like a, really? That's the origin? Instead of being like, well, you encompass a lot of willpower, so you're now the new Green Lantern. Instead, it's just like, oh, you'll do. Because you're here. It's like you never see Batman or Superman come in and just being like, oh, well, you know, you're here, you'll do. You'll be our next hero. To add in the black areas. Yeah, just mechanical pencil will not do. Thought I had a HB lead pencil. I'm just gonna grab one real quick. Alright. Let's grab my sharpener. And this is just your basic average everyday mechanical pen, or everyday pencil, wooden pencil. Nothing fancy about it, just a regular pencil. Which, here's another advice, about drawing. Doesn't matter what supply you use, as long as you know how to do the actual art, supply means nothing. So it's the supply is just more of a preference. Like for me, I like using, you know, harder lead pencils because it works for me. It, you know, it doesn't smear the page as bad. And I like using mechanical pencils because they're a lot easier to deal with. I don't have to sharpen them every single time, you know, they start to turn into a nub. So it's all about preference on that part, but as for like whether or not you need to use a particular type of pencil, that doesn't matter. It's all about you knowing how to do the art. I mean, for years I didn't even use mechanical pencils. I just, you know, used regular pencils, even like the old big mechanical pencils. I used those and used regular lead because, you know, it was cheap for me. It was, you know, didn't cost that much. But over time, when I was able to afford, you know, better supplies, you know, that's when I went this route where I decided to use, you know, lighter lead and thicker mechanical pencils, or at least a thicker lead and pencil holders instead of using regular mechanical pencils. Even the paper I used, like, you know, when I was young, I just used whatever paper was there. I mean, I just wanted to learn how to draw properly, not, you know, find the item that, you know, find the piece or the supplies that, you know, would make my art, you know, 10 times better. It was just more of me learning how to draw, and supplies being the second thing to worry about. Right now, I'm just rendering this guy, you know, adding the black areas, making sure that he pops a little bit, because most of his costume is black. It's black, and then white, and then your green on the areas right here, and then, of course, flesh tone here, which I'm probably going to just do that during Photoshop, or when I'm coloring it on Photoshop. I think it'd be a good idea for me to do this on Photoshop, or at least coloring it on Photoshop. I mean, I like doing gouache, but it's a bit of a process, and I have to, like, stop every so often to kind of make sure I'm not, you know, missing anything, or doing anything crazy. And there's, of course, there's a lot of shading going on with that one, because you want to make sure that this image actually, you know, looks good. Be careful of my ink and water. Don't not want that stuff spilling onto my this, because otherwise it'd be ruined, and the stream would be over, and I'm laying in my bed crying, because it's all ruined. No, I'm not going to cry about it. I may get upset over it. Sharpen this again. Almost done with the pencil stages. Broken. Hey Jenna, what's up? The downside about using old pencils. It is not wanting to work again. Try this one. Okay, that'll do. Are you still at work? Done with this. Probably do the armor portion too. Use the other
do believe the pencil stages are done. Give you a closer look at this. So, we'll do. I'll add the black areas to this. Actually, before I do that, I'm gonna go ahead and take a picture of this and post it. Just need to get my camera up and running. Post this up real quick. And we add in okay. Grab the thing again. I need my tablet for references. Actually, you don't even need the tablet for references. Okay, now back to what I was doing. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just do the black areas first.
think, I'm starting to think that I poured too much ink onto my bottle or my cup. So this might take a lot longer to dry. Luckily enough, I have my fan on. So hopefully that'll speed up the process just a little bit. Now the reason I'm adding the black areas first is because I want to, well, it's a way to trick my brain into thinking that this piece is, almost done. I do that sometimes on, well, not sometimes, most of the time on pages that I work on. I'll pencil everything, and then, any areas that are on black, like just solid black, I'll just do those first, and that definitely just gives me the impression that this thing's almost done. You forgot an area. Okay, I see an area that has way too much ink on there, so we'll just do this. I think it's drying up now. Okay. This will actually look really nice with colors. I already know like what colors I'm using, what background I'm going to use. So I'm very excited about that part. Not to say that, you know, this isn't like boring or anything. I actually do like how this is turning out. Hey Sandra, what's up? A little bit more ink. That's way too much ink. Here we go. That could have been a major mess if I started inking this with that much ink on my brush. Every once in a while, I've got to check the brush just to make sure that there's no excess ink that's going to smear my piece. Now, since that area is drying, I'll work on the upper section. Okay, let's try it up. Looks like I've been at this for about an hour. It's nice. Sometimes with stuff like this, I tend to lose track of time. And there have been times where I've lost so much track of time that I just completely forget to eat something. So I end up the day with, like, just me having massive headaches and realizing, oh, you know, dude, I just didn't eat at all. Because I've been working on this one project for a very long time. For the hair. Now for the hair, I'm gonna look around some areas with the brush so that you'll see like all these little excess strands from the brush. It kind of gives it, kind of makes the hair look a little bit more realistic. I kind of have to move the page around, make sure that the areas that I inked earlier are completely dry, so I can just jump on, so I can get a little bit closer to the hair here. Give him a few more strands of hair to kind of roll around with. Here we go. Alright. So that's it for the black areas. As you can see, it looks like it's almost done. But really, I still have some more to go. I have to kind of work on the outline, then the deeper details, even more rendering to kind of deal with, which is just not going to take that long. But I am going to use my dip pen here. Where should I start? It's not wanting to work for me. There we go. There was some pieces that I work on, I'll usually use a thicker, or I'll use a brush, or just regular marker pens, but because of his gauntlets, I kind of want to use dip pen because it's a little bit more precise. And I don't want to rush this either. When I'm using this pen, best thing about this pen is the handle, or the holder. I just like how it feels. It's nice and comfortable. Doesn't feel like I'm struggling with the pen. Thinking after this about getting some food. I'm already hungry as it is. Which I need to stop. I need to actually start taking frequent breaks whenever I'm doing these projects and actually getting something to eat instead of so just like working non-stop and then not thinking about food, and by the time that happens, I have to go to bed. And I don't want to be late on that. Okay. So that gauntlet's good. is still being dried. Okay. So I'll just continue on with this section. Usually force out the ink. I'll have the pen on top of the actual cup of water and shake out the pen, mainly because of how these things actually hold, you know, a good amount of ink, but you can actually squeeze out just a little bit more before you have to reapply. Squeeze out a little bit more ink so that you can actually, you know, get the areas that you need to fill out done quickly. Face last, that's why I'm not jumping into that area too soon. We're gonna apply more ink. It's clogged up right now. Here we go. We'll do that ring with the fine tip pins. Actually, I will use the pins for the mouth.
Can I use small? An extra small. Everything's dry up here. Okay, cool. I can use that'll do. Alright, I think that is it. Check on some areas here. I'll use the pen for the touch-ups. Make sure I'm not missing anything. Or if I need to add anything, it's there. Okay, that is it. That is my Green Lantern piece. Thanks a lot for joining. Not sure when I'm going to do the next stream. It might come up in the next few days, maybe next week. Haven't decided yet. But thanks a lot for joining. For you new guys, I'm on Facebook at Art of Jerry. I'm also on Twitter at Jerry G. Gonzalez. And yeah, that's it. You guys have a good night. And I will post the scan for this either tonight or tomorrow. And I'll have the colors ready by tomorrow, hopefully by tomorrow. But yeah, guys, have a good night. Bye.